Hello everyone. I'm going to talk about my thesis project, which is Risks of Interactive Communication, a Digital Literacy Proposal. In recent years, there have appeared a number of actors, like the internet, mobile phones, computers, internet, that influence in many aspects of our lives, like the leisure, the learning, the work, and also the communications. So, due to these technological advances and the inclusion of them in our life, the society has changed a lot, causing the emergence of the digital society. In this type of society, the relationships have changed a lot, especially the social and family relationships have changed a lot due to the technological advances. Teens are fully immersed in this new context of digital society, and they use a lot the interactive media. Thus, in 2001, there were 26% of children between 6 and 16 years old use the internet every day. However, in 2012, there were more than 70% of them who do it. And in the case of the children over 12 years old, there were more than 90% of them who use the internet every day. Moreover, 6 out of 10 children over 10 years old own a mobile phone, and after 15 years old, 9 out of 10 have it. In addition, the rooms have more and more technological equipment, and this has led to the bedroom culture, which is a tendency of children and young people to spend more and more time in their rooms with the digital and the communication media. So this situation causes that the parental control in use in time and in contents are much lower than previously. In any case, in this type of society, the digital society, the interactive communication is very important, and according to Scolari, the interactive communication is the communication mediated by digital technologies. And this occurs through tools like instant messaging, social networks, or the email, and through technologies like the computer, the mobile phones, or the video games. In any case, the interactive communication has possibilities and benefits, like that it keeps connected individuals in society, but it also has some disadvantages and dangers that are especially important in the case of the minors. For example, when we use a social network, we have to decide what type of information we want to be public and what type of information we want to be private, and with whom we want to share it. And mismanagement of this information could imply a privacy loss. As I said previously, these risks are especially important in the case of the minors because they need an special protection. And when the researchers and experts talk about risks of interactive communication, they usually refer to the exposure to pornography, the cyberbullying, the grooming or sexual harassment, the sexting, the contact with the strangers, and the impersonation. Thus, the 15% of minors of European children between 9 and 15 years old have been involved in a sexting activity. The 6% has received nasty or harmful messages online in the last year. Moreover, 1 in 3 children has contacted someone who they didn't know previously, and then face to face, and then 9% of them has met this person. A quarter of minors has provided personal information to strangers, and 10% of them have had their identity suppressed to be hacked. However, the 8% of the children don't care about this risk, and the 7% of them admit not knowing how to avoid them. The problem is that this risk could have serious psychological consequences. So, according to some researches, there is a link between suffering this risk and the risk of interactive communication, and suffering anxiety, depression, stress, sleep disturbance, frustration, irritability, eating disorders, suicide attempts, and even suicide. So, in this situation, some experts believe that children should be encouraged to take responsibility for their own safety. So we must focus on their training and the training of the digital skills to promote the digital literate. And this is because some authors believe that digital literacy is very important for the use of digital devices. So the more digitally literate children are, the more benefits they can get from these environments. And they will know better how to address the risk of the interactive communication. And in this sense, the digital literacy is more than a simple ability to use the software or the functions in a digital medium. It includes cognitive, motor, social, and emotional skills that the user needs to function effectively in a digital environment. It's very important to stress that we cannot deprive the adolescents of the use of the interactive communication. Moreover, it would be an impossible task. The solution is to give them the tools to be able to use these technologies safely. And these tools appear through a process of digital literacy. So therefore, our project aims to increase the digital skills of adolescents through two processes. A first process perform a diagnosis of digital skills, and a second process of intervention to digital literate these adolescents. With reference to the state of the art, in the last year there has been a boom in the research related to digital and interactive media. There are a lot of researchers who are related to the characteristics of the use of the digital media by adolescents and children. They, for example, about the frequency, the access, the equipment. However, the parents and the educators and researchers are very worried about the effects of the digital devices in their children. So there is a lot of research trying to delve into the risks of the digital media. In this sense, many of the research conclude alerting of the importance of taking measures and solutions to address this risk. And some experts stress the importance of the digital literacy as a prevention tool. Like occurs with the media literacy and the communication media. And this is the case of the funding project in which this research is placed.
Alfabetización mediática, diseño, ejecución y evaluación de un programa de intervención con adolescentes.
So, in the case of our research, the goal is to increase digital skills, and to do this instead of using a classical education intervention, we will elaborate a mobile application with this literacy goal. And we will consider two theoretical frameworks. First, the strategy of entertainment education, which refers to the intentional placement of educational content in the entertainment messages. And secondly, the narrative persuasion theory. And according to this theory, the use of narrative fictions produce a greater impact on knowledge, aptitudes, and behaviors than the traditional format does. Moreover, the transportation and identification with the characters are effective in producing cognitive and emotional effects that involve attitudinal and behavioral changes. In conclusion, due to the fact that the narrative format can be a valuable tool for prevention, we will develop an application with a narrative content. So, our research objective goal is to improve digital skills in adolescents with the aim that they could afford with endangers the risks of interactive communication and maximize the opportunities that this communication gives to them. With reference to the methodology, this project will be conducted through three studies that will be complementary to each other, but that will be carried out in different phases. First of all, we will do a survey because the goal of this project is to improve the digital skills of the adolescents. We would need to know previously the level of the skills that they have. So we will develop a questionnaire with a scale which will measure the different digital skills. Secondly, we will conduct an experiment in order to check whether the degree of digital literacy influences the degree of gratification obtained with digital contents. And this is because some experts stress the importance of the digital security, the security in the internet, doesn't restrict the new opportunities on the net. And finally, we will develop the application. So we will conduct an experiment in order to see if the application is effective to digitally literate, and more specifically, whether the narrative persuasion is effective in persuading and educating. In conclusion, the risks of the interactive communication are becoming more numerous and dangerous by day, especially for minors. And in this situation, some experts stress the importance of the digital literacy as a prevention tool. And that's why we do in our project research. Finally, with reference to the current and expected contributions, this project aims to test how the strategic use of interactive and multimedia contents can be an effective tool for the prevention and reduction of the risk associated with the interactive communication. So this research aims to advance in the study of prevention through narrative persuasion, and that's an area that hasn't been addressed in the investigation of the risk of interactive communication. And that's all. Thank you very much.